the red trunks, white trunks of red trim. Jesse Toro out of Seattle Eagles gym and the white trunks of the black trim. Two rounds gone, Gordy, and I thought Ollenberger won both those rounds convincingly just by the number of punches he threw.
Oh yeah, he's going to the body really effectively now.
Now he does, again, right there, he's slapping a little bit, just a little bit. When he gets those straight punches, he's a lot more authority on them and he does a lot more damage as well.
Well, he's keeping busy is what he's doing. And he don't care if he's slapping a little bit. He's just trying to upset the challenger, Jesse, here, and he's digging to the body really well.
He should keep that right hand up a little bit more, though, because that's been the one effective punch for Jesse Toro, that left hook over the top of that.
Oh.
Just scoring at will against Jesse Toro, James Ollenberger is. Turning into a bit of a mismatch, but Toro, you're going to have to knock him down to finish him off, Gordy.
Oh, yeah, that Jesse looks like he's a tough little nut there. He's taking some good shots there, and he doesn't even blink. I think the only thing that's going to wear him down is his fitness. We don't know how much of a conditioned fighter he is. He's going to start getting tired. Those shots to the body, those hooks right there are going to wear him down. His mouthpiece is out now.
Now, how much of an effect will that have, Gordy? Does the mouthpiece help you that much?
Well, it's something to bite on. If you get hit in the jaw, there's always a chance of having a broken jaw. And if the mouthpiece is in, you've got something solid, you know, to bite on. It's going to set your jaw firm. And, you know, plus the psychological feeling that, you know, you have a bit of protection anyway.
I think the one advantage, if there is one, to losing your mouthpiece, you can breathe a little bit better, can't you?
Well, yeah, definitely, but, you know,
you'd rather have it in there.
You'd much rather have it in.
Ollenberger just taking control of this fight. Not much doubt that he's ahead on everybody's card, but then again, you never know in the sport of boxing. We find that in that Holmes-Cooney fight just recently completed, up until a knockout, had it not been for the points taken away from Jerry Cooney, Holmes would have lost it. Same thing with the Sugarman Leonard Duran 2 fight, and Hearns Leonard fight. Leonard was behind on all cards until the fight went. So you never know in this sport, Gordy.
Never know, no way. See, a shot like that, hit right, you know, you never know, it might finish the fight. Jesse's still in there, he's still swinging, and that's the end of the game.
And Ollenberger continues to stack up points. Seven punches in a row, but none of them real hard. He's got a bit of a low blow, I think, there, wasn't it, Gordy?
No, I don't think so. It was just right on the money.
It was close.
Got
the top of the belt. Toro's a little bit of blood oozing out of the...
She's the round's over with now.
Oh, yeah, the bell went.
Fight's over.
He didn't get up in time, couldn't be stopped by the bell, and the fight is over. Shocking upset. The semi-main event, James Ollenberger wins by a knockout in the fourth round after the bell had gone. That's it. Victory. Yet another victory for Kingsway Boxing Club. And that's it from...
To win it, he's going to have to really fight. And I don't think it's a chance.
Okay, you've never seen Jamie fight, but I guess you've heard a lot about him. How do you plan on fighting him?
I plan on knocking him out.
Just going to knock him out just like that?
Just going to do it just like that. I can't predict no round or nothing, but I think it'll be a heavy fight, and I think he's going to do a good classical job. I think he's a good fighter, and I don't disrespect him. But this is mine, and he got to come and take it. And that's going to be real hard, and I really feel like that tonight it'll be a spectacular fight.
Okay, now he's a southpaw. Have you fought very many southpaws, and how do you do with southpaws?
Last southpaw I fought, I got his belt. So I'm not really leery of a southpaw. I feel like he's a good fighter, and I'm not going to disrespect him. I work with southpaws, and I train for this fight real hard because it's in my heart and it's in my blood to win this fight because it could take me to bigger and better things.
Gentlemen, the main event of the evening will be 12 rounds of boxing, and the Pacific Northwest Welterweight Championship title is on the line. Introducing in the blue corner, wearing white trunks, weighing in at 145 pounds, he has a professional record of 11 wins, no losses, and one draw. 9 by knockout. Please welcome the Western Canadian champion, Jamie Ollenberger. Ollenberger. And in the red corner, wearing red, white trunks with red trim, weighing in at 146 pounds, he has a professional record of 12 wins, 2 losses, 10 by knockout. Please welcome the Pacific Northwest Welterweight Champion, the Executioner, Tony Thomas. Bill Thornburg is the man in charge.
Welterweight Championship on the line, scheduled for 12. We've got a former Oregon Golden Glove champ and the former Canadian National champ. And they're going at it for the Northwest Welterweight Championship. First defense for Tony Thomas since here at the Marriott back in December, he had a fifth-round TKO over Francisco Roche.
Yeah, I'll tell you, this has got me excited. This is an excellent fight. It's one that I've been looking forward to some time. These are the two best welterweights in the Northwest.
Here we go, scheduled 4-12, live main event boxing on TV 49 from the Marriott Hotel. I'm Mike Stone along with Dusty Isasaga.
One thing we can look for, you got your basic boxer and puncher here with Ollenberger being the boxer and Thomas being the puncher. Thomas is a slow starter. And Thomas, a former Oregon Golden Gloves champion, has really turned out to be a much better pro. He hits awfully hard.
And of course, Thomas, if you were here in December when he took the title and attained it from Roche, again, got off to a slow start. About the time everybody was wondering where that thunder was, he unleashed it in the fifth round.
Jamie Ollenberger is no slouch. He made the Canadian Olympic team in 1980. Canada elected not to go to the Olympics that year, but he was the representative there at 139 pounds.
So both fighters wearing white. The Executioner, though, and the Skull and Crossbones will signify Tony Thomas to you.
Ollenberger throws a little bit more combinations. There he goes. Nothing landed, however. But he can't really take liberties with Tony Thomas. Tony is really a devastating puncher with the right hand.
Good body shot from Ollenberger. And he came up flinching, ready to put up the guard, waiting for that right hand from Thomas. Did not get it.
That's right. They're well aware of Thomas's punching power.
Tony Thomas can ill afford to lay back too much with a guy like this because points. This guy can add up points on you quickly until where Thomas can back himself into a corner where he has to knock him out.
Well, Arnold Manning, who is the trainer of Tony Thomas, says that if it goes 12 rounds, he expects Ollenberger to win it. He also expects Tony Thomas to knock out Ollenberger within 8.
Well, keep an eye on that prophecy. Good right hand by Thomas. Glancing actually off the chin of Ollenberger, but you notice Ollenberger respects it, backs away. Trying to get Thomas in his corner to throw more punches and hear him shot down there.
Well, again, Thomas is a slow starter. Really didn't expect him to come out wild here in this first round, and normally it takes him a couple of rounds to really warm up.
His first title defense, the Northwest Welterweight Championship on the line.
Nice stiff jab by Tony. Another thing that a lot of people are overlooking, and that is Tony does have the big punch, but he also has good boxing skills, too.
The Western Canadian champion, Jamie Ollenberger, against Tony Thomas, winding down the first of a scheduled 12-round championship fight, and the subcard was outstanding tonight here at the Marriott. We'll see some highlights at the conclusion of this fight. Here we are at the end of round number one, live from the Marriott Hotel. His handler is telling him quit reaching with that jab, trying to set up the right. Do you think he's trying a little too hard early to set up that right?
Well, he might, but one thing I want them to do is close the gap between them so he can reach him with the right hand. But Ollenberger will have a lot to say about that. He'll try to stay away, of course.
Punch bothered the right eye of Ollenberger.
He may have caught a little bit of a thumb or possibly
a... You notice his eye was flinching a bit on that?
Yeah, he was blinking that time.
Still blinking a bit from the effects of it. Good shot to the bridge of the nose by Tony Thomas with his jab.
Tony looking lean, and both these young men have worked very, very hard for this. And I'll tell you, it was a toss-up coming in. Nice counter shot to the body by Tony Thomas.
Hey. Thomas, the Northwest Welterweight champ. Good combination by Ollenberger. Missing to the right is Tony Thomas, just about midway through round number two. Outstanding night tonight.
Boy, there's been some just tremendous fights on the undercard tonight.
Oh, yeah. The best we've seen in a while. You're watching live boxing from the Marriott on TV 49, the home of the Seattle Mariners.
Tony Thomas now starting to put a little bit of pressure on Jamie. Backing him up. But this is a typical Thomas fight. Good dig to the body by Thomas.
Tony Thomas, good straight right that time, reaching just a bit with it. Gets in a little bit closer and lands like that. Ollenberger could be down.
Ollenberger can also hit to the body. Really hasn't shown it here. He knocked out his last opponent, who was a 154-pounder, a junior middleweight, with a shot to the body in the first round. Oh, that was a hard dig to the body by Thomas.
Thomas showing his own decent boxing skills here in round number two. Overhand right just missed. Under 30 seconds to go in round two. Las Vegas-style boxing it is here in the beautiful downtown Marriott. Scoring with a combination again with the left-right combination as they come to the conclusion of round two boxing away championship bout from the Marriott. Both fighters remain composed through the first two rounds.
Pretty close fight, I'd say. I think Ollenberger probably took that first round. Thomas may have come back and won the second.
Ollenberger off balance, lunging forward, but he avoided any serious harm from the couple of wild punches of Tony Thomas. We're seeing two excellent conditioned boxers.
Tony keeping the gloves up high and blocking those punches by Ollenberger.
Ollenberger likes to throw in combinations. The pre-fight buildup had this as the boxer and the puncher, but Tony Thomas, as you have alluded to him here this evening, possesses better boxing skills, perhaps, than some give him credit for.
There you go. And that's going to happen to anybody that can punch a little bit. They forget about his boxing skills. You just can't go in there and knock folks out. You got to know how to do it.
But he's still reaching. He's not doing yet what the corner wanted him to do, to get in closer. He is not landing with full effectiveness.
No, but again, you know, Jamie Ollenberger has something to say about that. He's a very experienced boxer. And he'll try to keep away from the power of Tony Thomas. And being a southpaw, he's looking right down the barrel at a big gun there in the right hand of Tony's.
At the end of this round, we'll give you an opportunity to go in and eavesdrop in the corner of the Northwest Welterweight champ, Tony Thomas. We're just about midway through round number three. Thomas with 12 wins, 2 defeats. 10-0-1 is the recorded record for Jamie Ollenberger, the Western Canadian champ in this division.
In trying to get a line on how this one was going to go, and just talking to the boxing people in the Northwest, really, this thing is just about a toss-up. Everybody up in Seattle area feels that Ollenberger has got too much boxing, and everybody down here feels that Tony is just too strong.
Well, Ollenberger throwing a lot of punches here in round three, missing quite a few in that exchange. Thomas eluding the punches, still comes in.
And digging to the body.
Well, I'll tell you, some right shots from Tony Thomas to the body over an extended period of time will take its toll. Under 30 seconds in round three.
Tony, good
right that time.
And Ollenberger handled it okay.
This is just a continuation of what has been an outstanding night here at the Marriott. Winding down round number three, and we're going to keep it here. Third round is over, and both fighters looking good at this point. Tony Thomas, and let's go into the corner right now. Tony Thomas.
He ain't working yet.
Open up a new jab like he's telling you.
He's dropping, almost dropping with a body shot. Get back in that body. Get back in that body. You see him? You almost dropped him with that body. Get back to that damn body.
Double up on those jabs and pitch your right hand in here, and he'll drop into it for you.
I was a little better. Watch him now. You can get more opportunities to love it. That's enough. Hit that body. Hit that chain to him. Hit that body. You're almost dropping with that fucking body shot. Michael Eisen is right, man.
Thomas will be to work to the body, as they emphasize in the corner, go to work on the body.
That's Arnold Manning, who has really done an excellent job with several Northwest fighters since really coming onto the scene and just becoming the number one trainer in the Northwest.
All right, round four, scheduled for 12. Tony Thomas, the champ, down from Canada. Jamie Ollenberger trying to take another local title. He is the Western Canadian champ. A moment ago, he may have saw an unintentional low blow from the right of Tony Thomas.
He's the Western Canadian champion, but boy, he'd like to have this Northwest championship.
I would think if I were Jamie Ollenberger, I would not want to do too much infighting with Tony Thomas.
No, I guess the strategy coming in was supposed to be Jamie boxing on the outside.
Hey, he's willing to mix it up. Left, right, followed, but missed by Tony Thomas. Good exchange, both punchers scoring that time.
Ollenberger with a left. Jamie's going to have to do that. He's going to have to land a left hard enough occasionally to keep Tony at bay. Tony's just starting to walk in and load up.
Boy, the action speaks for itself in this one. We have two well-conditioned fighters, two well-schooled fighters. I think it's easy to say through midway through this, the fourth round, this is already our finest main event.
I think it's the best matched main event we've had, in that it was just impossible to figure out who's going to win ahead of time. And this one's got a long ways to go.
Only in round four, Thomas, the champ of the Northwest, the executioner, Tony Thomas. Remember now, he is the kind of fighter. He won this in a fifth round TKO over Francisco Roger here at the Marriott in December and just did pretty much what he's doing now.
Nice left by Ollenberger and a nice hard stiff jab, and there's the right hand.
I don't know if I was Ollenberger's corner, I'd want him to take a right from Thomas, then lean back on the ropes and wait and see if another one's on its way. But perhaps he's comfortable there fighting off the ropes.
Well, Ollenberger just landed a left. There he goes with another left, but it just doesn't have the steam on it.
He's scoring points, so I'll tell you. If he can avoid trouble under 30 seconds in the round, he is scoring points in those combinations. But he is not the harder of the punches.
Push him off, get off.
Boy, they're right in front of each other right now. Both of them are in range.
Now Ollenberger scoring and Thomas mugging. That's not smart to do. We'll be back for round five.
Riley here from the Waterbed Factory, offering you two beds for the price of one during the grand opening of our new store on 82nd Street. When you buy the Cheyenne with mirror, bookcase, headboard, glass doors, and a 12-drawer pedestal, you'll get a free super single waterbed. Down payments start at just $39.95 and monthly payments are only $42.83. Plus, you don't make a payment for 3 months. It's our buy one, get one free sales happening now at both locations of the factory. The Waterbed Factory, Southwest Beaverton Hillsdale Highway, and now on Southeast 82nd Street.
The largest inventory in the Northwest, a $5 million selection. The Sailorama of motorhome values at Fred's Travelrama is on. If you've ever considered a motorhome, come to Fred's Travelrama today for a gigantic selection of models and interiors at special Sailorama prices. Like this comfortably stylish, fully equipped 22-foot Winnebago Chieftain, only $289.99 a month. Fred's $5 million Sailorama, where customers become good friends.
This is Fred McNally, inviting you to come in today and see for yourself at Fred's Travelrama.
Ollenberger getting the better of it at the end of round number four as we start five, scheduled for 12. Ollenberger scoring, Tony Thomas doing a bit of mugging, but more often than not, that's a sign of, yeah, you scored.
Yeah, I'll tell you, another thing, too, that you pointed out during the break is Jamie Ollenberger appears to have suffered a slight cut over the left eye or possibly in the corner of the left eye.
They didn't have much trouble with it between rounds, but it will be something to watch.
Yeah, we're only in the fifth round of a 12-round fight, so.
Oh, Ollenberger scoring on Thomas, who was off balance, and Thomas a bit frustrated right now. Very impressive young Canadian boxer coming down.
Yep, he's throwing punches from all angles, too, so even though Tony has covered up real well, Ollenberger is still able to sneak a few through.
Ollenberger always punching, always moving, punching in combination, scoring in combination. Round four appeared to be Ollenberger's round. Round five, he appears to be in control. Look at that combination, scoring again and again on Tony Thomas. But remember the thunder in the right hand of Tony Thomas. Everyone was in the corner told you earlier, past round eight, they think that Ollenberger would have the advantage.
Well, they feel that if it goes the distance, that Ollenberger will win, and if there's a knockout, then it would come from Tony Thomas, and that's probably about right.
So far here, and again in round five, Ollenberger doing the most effective punching.
Oh, nice uppercut by Ollenberger. Good right and a left by Thomas.
This is outstanding boxing from the Marriott tonight. Northwest Welterweight Championship bout, and they are fighting like it's a championship bout.
Yeah, don't kid yourself, really. These guys are fighting hard for the Northwest title. These guys are the best in the Northwest, and it is a title, and it's a region that really, I mean, it's nothing you can just stick your nose up to. It means something to these guys.
I'm not going to put my nose up in there. They'll knock it off.
I hear that.
Reacting now, Thomas wadding in.
Ollenberger looking a lot better in these last couple of rounds.
Yep. Well composed young boxer for having only 12 professional fights. Wow, right hand by Thomas, but again, Ollenberger weathers it nicely and comes back with combinations off the rope.
Thomas, awful strong, just landed a pretty good left there.
Always the danger of the thunder in the right from Tony Thomas. Hey. Has been known to lull opponents to sleep and then unleash a wild attack led with a right. You're watching live boxing on TV 49 KPDX from the Marriott Hotel.
He wants to cash a check. I'll need a credit card, two IDs, birth certificate, signature voucher, and a note from your mother or wife.
Hey, wait a minute. This is an out-of-state check. He wants to cash an out-of-state check.
No problem. Here comes the check exchange, check cashing centers. We cash check refunds, government checks, personal checks, insurance drafts, and any good check. For instant cash 7 days a week, go to any of these three Portland area check exchange locations.
Wow, a new cereal.
Feeling like cinnamon toast, feeling like cinnamon toast crunch. Feeling tasty,
feeling new,
feeling crunchy.
Wow.
Like cinnamon toast crunch.
New cinnamon toast crunch cereal, sprinkled with cinnamon and sugar for the delicious taste of homemade cinnamon toast. Part of this nutritious breakfast.
Feeling toasty,
feeling sunny,
feeling cereal, feeling
funny. Feeling like cinnamon toast crunch.
Ready? Round six. I'm Mike Stone, along with Dusty. Boxing is my life. Issa Saga from the Marriott Hotel. Ollenberger, Jamie Ollenberger, in the all-white trunks from Canada, against the Northwest champ, welterweight division, Tony Thomas. Last two rounds, you would have to think Ollenberger got the definite best of it.
Yeah, Tony really did come on pretty good in the last part of that round. This is a real good fight. Both of them are very evenly matched, and gosh, you know, you expect somebody to run into one here shortly.
It's been a lucky night for boxing fans, Friday the 13th. This has been, I've been coming for the last year every month, and this has been one of the finest nights.
Oh,
first
big,
one, hello.
Big right hand by Tony Thomas, a looping right this time. Tony's really loading up, and Ollenberger had better get off the ropes.
I would think so. I wouldn't want to get too cute with a guy like Tony Thomas on the ropes and try to intimidate him into missing. It only takes one that doesn't miss, and it's all over. there's Ollenberger right in front of him, Dusty.
He's right there, and this is something that a lot of people felt would get Jamie in trouble, and that is he has a tendency to trade, and they just a lot of people just don't feel he has the big punching power to stay and trade with a guy like this. But then again, you don't know how he can take this punch of Tony Thomas. If he can handle the punch, he's going to be... He's going to be in good shape in this fight.
Slight welt, it appears, a very slight one under the right eye. Of Ollenberger, we had alluded a couple of rounds ago to a possible cut in the left eye, in the left corner. But it's no problem, has not been a problem.
Well, I'll tell you, he's got some good corner people over there. Dick McDonald and his manager, Tony Dowling, real colorful characters, and they really know the boxing business, and they're the kind of people you want in your corner if you do get a cut or hurt.
Both corners have obviously done their pre-fight preparation very well, as have both fighters. You can see for yourself the excellent condition they are in. Round six. Good left that time by Thomas.
Oh, nice little uppercut by Tony, but he really hasn't hurt Ollenberger yet.
That body shot with the right, part of it got in. Ollenberger has thrown more punches in our first five rounds. Oh, another good right by Tony Thomas. Ollenberger wants to catch his breath after that one.
Well, you know, you have to pace yourself in a 12-round fight, and a few of the rounds you're going to have to just try to coast if you can to try to regroup. Oh, there's a nice combination by Ollenberger, a nice defensive move, ducking.
Thomas tried to wheel him around, but has yet been able to score effectively as he gets Ollenberger back into Tony Thomas's corner. We're coming down to the end of round six, and Thomas leaning against the ropes.
That's kind of surprising. I don't know if Tony is hurt or what.
Round six is over.
Sunday on the Movie of the Week.
By a punch, it looks like he just ran out of steam.
That could be. He may have taken a body shot in there that took it out of him momentarily. Yeah. But again, this is Tony Thomas' style. I've seen him so many times appear to be tired, taking too many punches, and all of a sudden he unleashes the big right hand, and it's a KO win. So even though it appears that Tony Thomas is tired, Jamie Ollenberger had better be careful and not get too carried away.
They've got 12. It's scheduled for 12. This is round seven of the Northwest Welterweight Championship bout. First defense for Tony Thomas, the champ. Ollenberger, the challenger out of Vancouver, British Columbia.
Tony really covers up real well. He looks in pretty good shape as far as damage. Oh, big right hand by Tony.
Thomas trying to take advantage into the corner. Could not do it, though. Ollenberger got out of the way.
Takes
slapping right that time by Thomas, not his hardest.
Not his hardest, but he almost got it. There's another one. Thomas starting to open up a little bit here.
Ollenberger can't be taking a whole lot of those rights, whether they're full effect or not.
No, he's got his left hand up higher by his chin now, though.
Good thinking. So Thomas starting to find the range with the right, not reaching his bar. He's within range now, getting closer to his opponent, Jamie Ollenberger.
And this could be a little discouraging, too, for Thomas, or for Ollenberger, rather. At the end of the round, it looked like, nice left by Thomas. It looked like Thomas was running out of gas, and all of a sudden, here he comes out here like a demon.
And look at the confidence come across the face of Tony Thomas. You can just see the change in expression. Well, thought about it, but too far away was Ollenberger, so he didn't waste the punch.
Boy, this has been a good fight. It's been a seesaw battle.
Busy fight. Both fighters have a right to be tired at the end of each round. They've been working.
And it's been one of those ebb and flow type fights where the fighter will take the initiative and then...
Thank you, Howard.
Okay. And then the other one will come back and take over. It's been a good fight.
Ollenberger looking for an opening as Thomas ducking down. Both fighters were slowing up a bit. Now Ollenberger trying to pick it up in the latter moments of round number seven. Missing there. Ollenberger showing the effects. A couple of arm punches.
Big body punch by Tony Thomas scored just a moment ago. Those are big, big punches. He's got to be careful. Ollenberger does.
Now see how Tony Thomas reacts as we wind down round number seven. We're under 25 seconds to go. And he looked tired at the end of round six. Ollenberger, however, the one leaning in the ropes. Can Thomas do anything about it? Trying to find room for the right hand. So far, no scoring as Ollenberger laying against the ropes. Ollenberger puts one in on the hip of Tony Thomas, who's in through the ropes as we wind down round seven from the Marriott Hotel.
Roland Ollinger for Ollinger Gladstone Dodge in Happy Rock. The end of a model year means extra special cleanup sale prices starting now. Look for these one-time only prices in the front windshield. Here's your chance to buy the new Dodge car or truck of your choice. In just a few weeks, our 85s will be arriving. Shop now and save more for a new Dodge while the choice and price is in your favor. Make your first stop at Ollinger Gladstone Dodge in Happy Rock.
Hi, Riley here from the Water Bid Factory, inviting you to our buy one, get one free grand opening of our new 82nd Street store. When you buy the Maverick with mattress, heater, liner, and mirror bookcase headboard, you'll get a free super single water bid. Down payments of $28, monthly payments $20.29, plus you don't make a payment for 3 months. It's our buy one, get one free sale happening at both locations of the factory. The Water Bid Factory, 8120 Southwest Beaverton Hillsdale Highway, and now on Southeast 82nd Street, Portland.
Interesting here, Mike, in how they're scoring this fight, because it's awfully close, I think.
Very close. And I think everybody at home will agree, and I imagine if you're in groups of two or more, you're having your own discussions and contradictions about who should be ahead in this fight. Imagine what it's like for the judges. Well, round eight, how critical will it be? The speculation was, if it goes past eight, it would be in Ollenberger's favor. Thomas, the harder puncher.
Well, I might point out, too, that even though Arnold Manning said that if it goes 12 rounds that Ollenberger will win, Tony Thomas disagreed.
He says,
he says if it goes 12, he'll win, whether he knocks him out or not, decision or otherwise.
One time.
Oh, there's a big right hand, almost landed there for Tony.
That's one time you don't mind if your boxer disagrees.
Yeah.
All right, Tony Thomas is the champ, the executioner. Still looking for room to land an effective right hand. He put about three or four of them on Ollenberger in round seven, but there is Jamie Ollenberger right in his face.
This one's going to get down to stamina, I believe. It's going to get down to those last few rounds. Who's going to be the freshest at the end?
Well,
there's a nice combination by Ollenberger.
But neither fighter can feel that confident to cruise in the next two or three rounds. They can't afford that. They've got to stay busy.
Exactly. They can't give away anything here. Like we were talking about, taking a break in various rounds. You're going to have to try to win as many as you can. Ollenberger, for instance, looking good in this round.
Again, throwing the more punches. Missing with that combination was Tony Thomas, the Northwest welterweight champ. And getting out with no problem is Jamie Ollenberger. A bit surprised that Tony has not been able to take more advantage of Ollenberger when he has leaned into the ropes. It's been an inviting target, but so far, Thomas has done nothing with that target. Ollenberger right in front of him.
It's a tough fight. The way these guys are throwing a lot of punches.
Left-hand scores by Thomas.
As far as going 12 rounds, Tony has never gone 12. He's never gone 10. Jamie Ollenberger has gone 12 one time. He's gone 10 several times. The one time he went 12 rounds is when he won the Canadian or the Western Canadian Championship.
And I think that's a key point you brought out. Regardless of what fighter may have the better punch, Tony Thomas, when he goes beyond this round, will be going the furthest ever in his pro career. Correct?
I believe that's, I'm trying to think of a 10 round. I haven't got the record in front of me, but I know Tony hasn't won a 10 round decision.
I've never seen him have to go 10 rounds here at the Marriott. Final 10 seconds, round number eight. So keep an eye on Tony Thomas's conditioning, and will the punches still be coming in flurries from the Canadian Ollenberger?
He wants to cash a check. I'll need a credit card, two IDs, birth certificate, signature voucher, and a note from your mother or wife. Hey, wait a minute. This is an out-of-state check. He wants to cash an out-of-state check?
No problem. Here comes the check exchange, check cashing centers. We cash check refunds, government checks, personal checks, insurance drafts, and any good check. For instant cash 7 days a week, go to any of these three Portland area check exchange locations.
Portland's got a great playground, a nighttime playground, in the Portland Marriott Hotel.
Gambits, where you can sip luscious concoctions, meet old and new friends. And what's a playground without games? Adult games like backgammon, or the game Gambits introduced to Portman, Pente. And dancing? Gambits got it every night of the week. Gambits, for great late afternoon and evening snacks, games, dancing. Gambits, where Portman goes out to play.
Well, the advice from the fans ringside makes it rather simple. Just knock him out, Tony.
Oh, it sounds so simple and looks so simple, doesn't it?
Round nine.
A little swelling under the right eye of Tony Thomas in the corner. If that continues to swell, that could cut down his peripheral vision and could present some problems.
And be awful hard to see from side to side, too.
Hey, there you go. That's very important, because when you do come up with those roundhouse punches, you just don't see them, and then they'll land, and you're not ready for them, and those, that's when you can get knocked out. So, Tony, if that swelling continues, could be in some trouble. And the cut for Ollenberger has held up pretty well. At least it hasn't reopened.
No problems whatsoever, with a very minor abrasion, apparently, on the corner of the left eye. That was early in this fight. Round nine, Thomas, his first defense of his welterweight title. And he has run into a tough one. Jamie Ollenberger from Vancouver, British Columbia. And Ollenberger has been throwing a lot of punches since the first round. Thomas has on occasion landed an effective punch, but Ollenberger has not been a real inviting target. Although
nope.
He has looked that way at times from ringside, you think that he's setting himself up by leaning into the ropes and standing right in front of Tony. But so far, Tony has not been able to do any serious damage.
No, Jamie has had a lot of experience, a lot of amateur experience, and he's had, 11 pro fights, so he's no slouch in there. He knows what he's doing.
Looks confident. He's taken some good shots from Thomas. Punches in combination. Excellent fight.
Thomas going to the body a bit. Not a bad idea.
But he's forced Thomas into the role of counterpuncher here. Thomas has been primarily counterpuncher the last couple rounds.
Yeah, and I think, there's a hard right hand by Thomas, but Ollenberger takes it pretty well.
Thomas trying to lunge and become more assertive and get off first. The lunging is deceiving, though. A little blood trickling down on the outside of the nose of Jamie Ollenberger.
Yep. That was a pretty hard right hand that Thomas landed on Ollenberger. Another one.
Thomas and Ollenberger exchanging center ring right now. Thomas missing with a straight right. Ollenberger, again, the left and the right. Combination puncher. Thomas, can he get him in the ropes again? No, nothing. Ollenberger gets out. Remember, you don't have to knock your opponent's head off, but if you're getting those punches in combinations, you're scoring. And that is what impresses the judges, along with one or two hard punches in a round. 15 seconds to go here. In round nine, stamina, you bet it'll be a factor. Never has Tony Thomas gone this far, to our knowledge. And one time, Ollenberger of Canada has gone 12. Round 10 coming up.
Hi, Riley here from the Waterbed Factory, and we're celebrating the grand opening of our new store on 82nd Street by giving away waterbeds. When you buy the Willamette with padded reader rest and headboard, you'll get a free super single waterbed. Down payments of $19 and monthly payments are less than $16. Plus, you don't make a payment for 3 months. It's our buy one, get one free grand opening sale happening only at the factory. The Waterbed Factory, Southwest Beaverton Hillsdale Highway, and now on Southeast 82nd Street, Portland.
The largest inventory in the Northwest, a $5 million selection. The Sailorama of motorhome values at Fred's Travelrama is on. If you've ever considered a motorhome, come to Fred's Travelrama today for a gigantic selection of models and interiors at special Sailorama prices. Like this comfortably stylish, fully equipped 22-foot Winnebago Chieftain, only $289.99 a month. Fred's $5 million Sailorama, where customers become good friends.
This is Fred McNally, inviting you to come in today and see for yourself at Fred's Travelrama.
10th round, off the stool first in center ring, ready to go, Jamie Ollenberger, the champ, Northwest welterweight champ, Tony Thomas comes out to meet him.
And a lot of folks didn't think it would go this long, but one thing we have to point out about Jamie Ollenberger is he's never been down in any of his fights. So he's already shown a pretty solid chin, and he's shown he's a tough young man in this one, as well as Tony Thomas.
Shot from Thomas, but again, Ollenberger eludes, allowing Thomas to load up and deliver more than one good shot at a time.
Still a fool. He feels that right. He gets out of the way.
That's right. And Tony's just loading up and trying to connect here.
Maybe he feels he has to. Go ahead. You at home play the guessing game. We're doing it ringside. I'm not ready to stick my neck out yet.
No, not me either.
Tony, stalking, looking to load up with the right, delivers, doesn't score. Now combination punches from Ollenberger that really off the arms of Tony Thomas.
One thing I don't... Oh, there's a nice left by Thomas. One thing, Tony Thomas is not going to just give up his title easily. He's not that kind of a guy. And Ollenberger knows that he has to win this fight. He'd like to stay undefeated and possibly set himself up for some Canadian championships with a win here.
Well, he scored about three or four times right there. They don't have to knock Tony Thomas back to count on the judge's card.
And again, this is the longest that Tony Thomas has ever gone in a fight. He's never gone 10 rounds. Eight was the longest. And he's asked to go 12 here.
Again, Ollenberger leans on the ropes, but just about the time Tony comes in to stalk and deliver, Ollenberger's gone. A couple of crafty fighters. Right now, very obvious, Thomas looking to unload. Is that right? Ollenberger still wants to score in combinations and stay out of the way. I think now, if we go beyond round 10, the pressure's definitely on Tony Thomas. Ollenberger can afford to stick and move more than Thomas can.
Yeah, but Tony's awful dangerous. He's still throwing those big, big punches. And
there's thunder in there, right. He's trying to get it in, just missed with it. Ollenberger, blood from the nose now. But ducking out of trouble, real trouble.
Boy, it's been a grueling fight for both these guys. And Thomas, for never going 10 rounds, is handling it thus far fairly easily, or at least fairly well.
Two more rounds to go. We will have a round 11. Coming up next, as our main event continues from the... This round, we'll go into the challenger's corner, Jamie Ollenberger.
Boy, these guys are in overtime now. 11 and 12. This probably will determine the outcome of this fight. Very important round.
Ollenberger looking to stay out of the way of that right hand right now. Just a tad low. No harm, though. Partially glanced off the arm. Thomas trying to go downstairs on a bad strategy late in this fight. Round 11. Ollenberger avoids serious problems. Blocking those body shots, trying to score with a right lead. Pity-pat punches that time didn't bother Tony.
That's right. Ollenberger's going to have to keep those elbows in.
You bet he is, and they're not getting... They're out now. Thomas can find room. Ollenberger just seems to know when Thomas is about ready to unload when he's along the ropes and just gets out of the way.
Tremendous fight by both these guys. Oh, there's a nice little combination by Ollenberger. Not a whole lot of steam, but again, those are scoring points for him.
Indeed, they are. But he has not been, if you've just tuned in, he has not been running from Tony Thomas. This man from Canada has stayed right in Thomas's face and has been willing to exchange at times.
Yeah, they've both been right in range, and it's been there's a lot of feinting going on in there. There's a lot of stuff happening in there between these two guys. It's an excellent fight.
No hype, no sales, just the plain truth. This has been one outstanding night of boxing at the Marriott. Started at 8 o'clock, and it's going right on now with an outstanding main event. The prelims are good, too, and we'll have time to give you a little bit of the highlights at the conclusion of this fight. Now, Thomas taking some shots, about four or five unanswered to the head.
Oh, these guys are reaching way down now to try to come up with some energy to finish out strong.
Now, Ollenberger doing more scoring here in round 11. My guess is no better than anybody else's, but I'm going to say Tony Thomas is going to have to come out in round 12 to make it that far and do some serious damage.
Gosh, I tell you, I couldn't make a decision right now.
Yeah, it's and I'm just basing that on the number of punches that have gotten in by Ollenberger. But again, he is the champ, and there is that theory that you've got to distinctly beat a champion to win. That's a theory, not necessarily a mandate.
And plus, you might point out that Tony is from Portland, by the way.
And that dude...
That do something
that
for
do
you.
That do come into play occasionally, not just in Portland, but with any hometown product. But Ollenberger scoring more here in round 11 by far than Tony Thomas. But 10 seconds to go in the round, and we will have round 12 of the Northwest Welterweight Championship bout. I'm sure you're going to be with us when we come back.
Jamie, you won that round very easy. We
now,
an instant replay of the last round.
Instant fucking replay.
And you want a bomb?
An instant replay out of Jamie Ollenberger. What they saw in round 11, they say you can win the fight if you can give us an instant replay of what you did in round 11.
Well, I'd say the Portland fans, Jamie's from Vancouver and all, but boy, I tell you, they cheered him on. They appreciate his performance, and it's been a gutsy performance by Tony Thomas. You know, he comes in as the executioner, and he comes in with the big puncher, and almost puts on a bad guy image. But he's a good man, introspective, and very intelligent young man. He's going to be in it toward the end. He's not going to give it up easy. This is should be a tremendous round.
I think the bell rang and the ref didn't hear it.
I haven't been able to hear the bell all night either.
Yeah, I heard the bell and the ref didn't hear it. Ron Blue, an old high school classmate.
You went to high school with Ron Ballou?
You bet I did.
Ron's a great guy.
He's Park Rose Bronco. Or was. Of course, Ron's forehead wasn't as high in those days. Let's get back to round 12 of our championship welterweight Northwest welterweight championship bout.
This is an excellent card, and hats off to the McNallys for putting on a great show here. They're going to take some time off until November, they say. And hopefully all the boxing fans will wait for that next show and come out and support all professional boxing wherever you're at.
2 minutes, 15 seconds to go in this fight. Round 12. I'm Mike Stone along with Dusty Isasaga. And it's been a pleasure for us to bring you the main events live on TV 49 KPDX. Before we get too involved in everything, what an outstanding job the crew for TV 49 has done. They are as sharp as anybody in the Northwest.
Oh, and just terrific people, you know. They don't intimidate you or not. They're just down-to-earth good people that know what they're doing.
Here we go, center ring. They want an instant replay from Ollenberger, and Thomas, has he got anything to throw? He's yet to throw a lot of punches here in round 12. He's got to get busy.
Tony landed a real good right hand just a moment ago.
Just one, though.
That could have ended it had it happened a little early. But
Ollenberger throwing a combination, scoring two or three get in. They don't have to knock the guy off his feet.
Need a big finish by somebody to pull this one out, whether it be Tony or Ollenberger.
Thomas missing with a lot of punches. There's another low one. He's had one punch in, and I've counted about 10 from Ollenberger that would score on a judge's card in this round. This is going to be tough for the judges.
Oh, it is.
No real clear decision. Both fighters have stayed busy.
There's
a right by Thomas, but look at Ollenberger.
Ollenberger
wobbled, but he stays there right in front of Thomas. Took another one.
And he better not do that because Tony will knock him out.
But is that enough? There's Ollenberger throwing him back.
Oh.
Ollenberger tired. Thomas tired. Reaching down inside the way you expect a champion to do. Will it be enough? Another right that stuns Ollenberger. Under 30 seconds to go. Jamie Ollenberger not looking good in the final minute. His corner, understandably worried. 20 seconds to go. Thomas would like to get one more right in there. Ollenberger bleeding around the mouth and nose.
Both these guys are dead tired. They've given their all tonight. Tremendous performance by them.
They'll be on their feet in less than 10 seconds as the Northwest Welterweight Championship fight from the Marriott Hotel is almost over. It has been outstanding. The decision in a moment.
The largest inventory in the Northwest.
15, 116, Ollenberger.
You have just witnessed an outstanding 12-round Northwest Welterweight Championship bout. Disappointment from the Portland fans, yes, but no disagreement. You hear their acknowledgement, it was the right decision. Your new Northwest Welterweight Champion is Jamie Ollenberger of Vancouver, British Columbia. And we hope to have an opportunity in just a couple of moments to have words with the new champ. Dusty Isasaga will secure him for us. And you saw the fight yourself. I was about ready to flip a coin through round number 8 and 9, but it was Ollenberger who continued to punch in combinations. Tony Thomas finally hurt and stunned Ollenberger in the 12th and final round, but 1 minute of stunning your opponent was not enough, apparently, for Tony Thomas to pull out a decision here in his hometown of Portland, Oregon. The crowd, very disappointed. They like Tony Thomas. He is a fine young man and a good boxer. However, they are acknowledging, in all sincerity, a right and just decision by the judges here ringside at the Marriott Hotel. The new Northwest Welterweight champ coming down now, Jamie Ollenberger from Vancouver, British Columbia. And it's a hard thing to do, number one, to knock off a champ, and number two, to come down and fight in the champ's backyard. So Ollenberger did two things. He took a title away from the defending champ, and he came in the champ's backyard and got the hometown decision to go his way. And his way was a lot of punches, a lot of combinations, stayed in the face, avoided trouble, sliding along the ropes. He gets congratulations from the former champ, Tony Thomas. Let's go now to Dusty Isasaga and your new Northwest Welterweight champ, Jamie Ollenberger.
Jamie Ollenberger, congratulations. A tremendous victory in a hard-fought fight for both of you guys. Boy, I'll tell you, that 12th round looked like a pretty rocky win for you, though.
Yeah, he caught me real good on the 12th round a few times. I just wanted to stay away and try and total up the points and outbox him. I felt I was edging the fight. It could have gone either way in my mind. He's a very hard puncher. I respect him very much. He's a great fighter.
Okay, now, what do we have in store for Jamie now? You got this
well,
title.
Well, Tony and I, I'm going to rest up a few days, get my eye healed up, get my body healed up a little bit, and I train real hard for this fight. I'm just going to keep in real good shape and wait for whatever comes up next.
Okay, Jamie Ollenberger, the new Northwest Welterweight Champion.
Problems that don't exist with his technique inside the ring, although he did suffer the first loss of his pro career last week. No, Ollenberger's problems have to do with the mighty greenback and the old clock on the wall.
Vancouver's Jamie Ollenberger is a professional boxer in need of time. The time to concentrate fully on his ring career. Right now, though, that is not possible. The 25-year-old welterweight holds down two jobs, one at a cemetery, the other a weekend position at a department store. His average day is grueling.
Well, I get up about 7, get to work, put in my full day at work, and then from work I go to the beach and run. Then I come to the gym, and I do my gym workout, you get to the gym as fast as you can, and then you put in about approximately 2 hours. Then after the gym work, I go to Sweatco, and I do an aerobics class there, and then by that time it's about 9:30, so I head home and shower and eat and go to bed and get up and do the same thing.
Not surprisingly, Ollenberger's rushed schedule has had a negative effect on his boxing. For example, last Friday night in Halifax, Ollenberger against Ricky Anderson, a Halifax native. Entering the fight, Ollenberger was the number 2 ranked welterweight in Canada, Anderson number 3. However, Anderson, fighting in front of a hometown crowd, enjoys many intangible advantages. He wins a unanimous 10-round decision.
He's got a manager who gives him a salary. He doesn't work. He just boxes. If we had this, there was no doubt we would have won that fight. In my mind or Jamie's mind. But when you go to a fight, we lacked, first of all, we arrived the night before the fight because Jamie had to work, right? We didn't have the proper time.
Again, the word time. As we all know, it means money. If Jamie Ollenberger needs time, he needs the bucks. In the world of pro boxing, that means financial backing.
We've had some offers, but they haven't been the right sort of people. I mean, you have to have people interested in the kid, not just in dollar bills. This is the problem with boxing right now. There are too many of the wrong sort of people involved in it. And Jamie Ollenberger is my type of fighter. He's a 100% fighter. And I want 100% people involved in it. All he wants is proper training, proper facilities, proper sparring, proper time.
Tony Dowling is willing to assume a lesser role in Ollenberger's career if the proper money people come through. Meanwhile, no matter what the financial situation, Ollenberger will carry on, positive and determined.
Whatever I have to do to be successful, I'm going to do. So whatever it means to do, if it's, you know, full-time working out, well, then I'm going to start working on that. And I feel that if I get the time and the opportunity to do so, I can
find some more sponsorship and some more monies to gear up again to bring yourself up to the old level for next year.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much, Dr. Hindmarsh.
Thank you very much for having
me. My guest has been Dr. Bob Hindmarsh. He is the athletic director at the University of British Columbia. Stay with us. Sports Insight returns right after this. Guest, at 25 years of age, is currently the number two ranked welterweight in Canada. Jamie Ollenberger, seen here defeating Portland's Tony Thomas for the Pacific Northwest title in July, will step into the ring again this Friday night. With a record of 10 wins and a draw, the road to the top has not been an easy one for Ollenberger, who absolutely lives to fight. This fight, Jamie, that you've got coming up, the next fight against Carl Owens, you fought him before.
Yes, I fought him before a few months ago. It was a very tough fight for me. Carl's a tall opponent, unorthodox, right-handed, who keeps coming, very good conditioned fighter. It's going to be another tough fight.
Friday night, and it is happening where?
It's happening at the Cloverdale Fairgrounds, and Scorpion Productions is bringing back boxing to Cloverdale.
There are other bouts on the card as well, then?
There's four other fights, which the semi-main event and the preliminary bouts will be very good fights.
Saying that you live to fight may sound like an overstatement, but tell me about your day-to-day routine. I think that'll make it clear that that's really what you do.
Well, basically, I get up in the morning at about 7. I go have breakfast, and then I head to work. I put in a full day's
work. The first job?
My first job is I work for the Masonic Cemetery Association of Burnaby, and then at 4:30 I get off, and what I do is I get into my car, and I head to the beach, and I run approximately 4 miles. And then from there, I'll go straight either, I have a schedule, Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. After the beach, I go straight to the gym and work out for a few hours, and then it's, you know, home, rest up, shower up, eat, and then it's to bed. Tuesdays and Thursdays, what I do is, after the beach run, I go straight to an aerobics class, Sweat Company, and I do my workout, and then I go to the gym. And then, as usual, I shower up, eat, and go home and go to bed.
But then you also have another job, don't you?
I work Saturdays at Woodward's, delivering furniture.
You are packing an awful lot of activity into your day. And I know that some people say that you have made an even greater sacrifice to your career. You gave up your marriage to be a better boxer. Is that what happened?
Well, that was back roughly 3.5 years ago as... I was an amateur. I made the 1980 Olympic team. We got married very young, so it had a thing to do with boxing, my wife being lonely, and also, you know, just being very young at that point. You know, that had something to do with it also.
How did you get bitten by the boxing bug in the first place?
Well, I started when I was 13, and it had seemed to me, like while I was going to school, other sports were a lot of fun. But boxing seemed to take a lot of dedication and a lot of hard training, and it was something that I liked to do as an individual, whereas the other sports were team sports. And so as I got into it more gradually, of course my dad helped me out a lot too, as taking me to the gym every night, 3 days, 4 days a week, and you know, helping me progress himself.
The decision to turn pro, therefore eliminating you from the 1984 Olympics in Los Angeles, was that an easy decision to make?
Well, I would have been on the 1981 World Cup team, and it was a decision to turn pro. There's a few things that were going on back then between my coach at that time and the Canadian, or not the Canadian Boxing Association, but the BC Boxing Association. So, I mean, a few members of the club were turning pro, and so I just went along with it.
Where does a professional welterweight go, though? What does the future hold for you?
Well, right now, being ranked number two in Canada, the possibility is a Canadian title fight, and taking it from there, I mean, I work my way through Canada, maybe possibly the British Commonwealth, and, you know, throughout the year, 1985 that is, I could work my way through the States, California, Vegas, etc., Reno, I may move down a weight division to 140 pounds, whereas I'd have a better chance of fighting.
But what about the money, though? That you are you ever going to be able to make the big dollars that the heavyweights make in with the kind of build and the kind of fighter that you are?
Well, that's hard to say. See, at any time or point in your career, you could get a lucky phone call saying, gee, a fighter backed out and we really need somebody to fill the spot. Would you take it for an X amount of dollars? And if, you know, provided, you know, I'm game to take anything that comes along at this point.
But there are purses for big dollars in those weight classes.
Sure there are.
Have you got a time frame set up for yourself? Do you know where you want to be at by the time you're 27 and by the time you're 29 and so forth?
Well, I'm not pushing to be anywhere. I'm just playing it by ear. Me and my manager, Tony Dowling, are taking the right steps, laying our cards out on the table right now, and you know, I think things will go well. Things have worked out for me so far. I'm undefeated in 11 fights.
Will you go on fighting until you achieve your goals, or will you say, I'm now 30 years old, let's say, and enough is enough?
I'm going to take it until my body can't take anymore. 30 years old, whatever I feel. When it's time for me to step out, I'll know, and I'm not going to go until I'm punchy.
But right now it's time to step in, and you've got some business to do with Mr. Carl Owens.
Yes, I got a fight that I want to complete this Friday night, and I intend to win it.
Good luck, and let us know how you do. Thank you.
In the
Tonight's semi-main event.